Now, I'm working on a lead right now that I already gave to Joe in my mentorship, and it's been a little bit of a doozy. We thought we had a closing date set, and the seller right now is giving us a hard time. It's not giving us a hard time. I mean, he's in a hard situation. When properties are occupied by sellers, it's kind of hard to get them out sometimes, you know, because they need a place to move. That's why a lot of people like dealing with vacant properties or properties that are not owner occupied, they're absentee owners, because sellers can give you a big problem. They won't leave on time. They have excuses. They can't pack. We have a seller right now who is in pre-foreclosure, is going to lose his home, have a foreclosure. Pretty much the house, we're selling it for like what he owes. He's not getting any money. We're just trying to help him. We're making a couple thousand. It's not even that big of a deal, but the seller is not moving. He's got excuses after excuse after excuse. And this is the reason. He's a hoarder. He doesn't want to move. That's it. He's potentially going to lose his property and go into pre-foreclosure with nothing and a ton of debt and bad record, because he just doesn't know what to do. So what do we do? Do we force him out of there? Do we just say, hey, we're going to take legal action. You signed an agreement and you're supposed to sell. We have a buyer lined up. It's a $10K wholesale fee, but he just doesn't want to move. I need to call the guy, find out if there's anything we can do to help him, because the guy just, he doesn't know what to do. Like, he doesn't know where to go. It's a sticky situation. He just doesn't want to go. He knows he needs to sell, but he's like got no idea what to do. So we're going to call him, and I'm going to call a couple other leads that I've received. I get leads for free because I know how to network. I've grown my brand, and you guys can grow your brand too to get leads for free. I don't like paying for leads, and you don't have to if you build your brand. But before you can get up to that point, you really have to, you know, cut your teeth and pay for the leads. And that's fine. I pay for some leads. I pay for some marketing, but majority I don't. And that's because of my brand and because I market it out. And, you know, having that been said, if you don't have a brand and you're paying for leads still, you need to check out the description right here. I work with an Egyptian company of cold callers. Amazing, amazing. And it's so inexpensive. My boy Daniel in Egypt, he's a baller. He manages the cold callers for you. You just got to give him the list and give him the dialer in. He'll make sure everything happens. Hit him up, fill out the form, and he'll hit you up. He'll call you from Egypt. And if you want leads from LeadZolo, hit me up. I can get you those. That's who I'm going to be calling. Now, dude, there's tons and tons and tons of ways to get leads. You guys, there's abundant amount. You don't have to just go spend and waste all your time and your money. My goal is to do business real estate part-time. I'm not trying to do this full-time if I can make as much money doing it part-time, right? No one's trying to work all the time. So that's what I'm here to show you. Let's call this seller right now and let's see if we can help the guy out, because again, I understand the situation. He does not moving, not because he doesn't want to go anywhere. He just doesn't have anywhere to go. What can we do to help this guy? You've got to think win-win. You got to love people and serve them. What can we do to help out this individual to succeed? All right. So I'm not going to share my screen with like what I do. That's like for mentorship members, but I will talk you through it. I'm just going to be calling him on my dialer right now. I use Google Voice in this situation because it's free. If you guys don't have Google Voice, you should get it. It's free. Let's call this seller right now. Let's just chat with him and see how we can help. So again, it's a sticky situation. The seller is going to lose his home, but he keeps on putting it off because he doesn't have a place to go. That's the main reason. I get it. I know. He does not sell it to someone else. But anyway, let's
call. Your call has been forwarded to an automated voicemail.
Okay, so he didn't answer. So what do? I call twice. I send an email and I send a text. That's what I do every time, just because, you know, getting a hold of people is like half the battle. You just got to get them on the phone. So let's call again. He's in bad reception.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice.
Okay, so we're going to call his wife right now. 804. Let's see. Okay. Let's see if his wife answers. Hi, Mrs. Shiflett. How's it going?
What do you want?
Oh, well, hey, I've been working with your husband, Mr. Shiflett, and Jackie, and I was wondering if you had a couple minutes to talk. I was just calling about the house.
I'm really so bad right now. No, I do not.
Yeah.
It has been calling.
Who's calling?
I don't know. People that says they want to buy the house. I don't know who they are.
Yeah, that's why I was calling, just to see if there's anything I could do to help. I understand you just got out of the hospital, and I heard it's pretty rough on you. Is that true?
Can I just talk to you later?
Of course, Ms. Shifley. When would be a better time to call? I want to see if I can help out. That's all. That's pretty much it.
How about if I just tell Ron to call you?
Yeah, of course. I called him, but his phone went right to voicemail, so I'm assuming he's just out of reception.
Yeah, he takes naps in between his jobs right now.
Okay.
But
yeah,
I will
have him call me. Yeah, and I wish you the best. I hope a speedy recovery, because I understand that it's probably just hard for you guys to find a place to go. You know, I'm assuming that's probably the problem.
Yep, sure is.
Yeah,
and I just don't understand how they can take all these houses and let them sit empty for months, and then give them to I don't know, their foreign people.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really frustrating.
And then
they
drive these big old black things, and it's so, the windows are so dark you can't even see them. Sometimes I sit and I watch them, and I see who gets out of them.
Yeah.
Those people that wears those long garments and wears those things on their head and all.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just not right.
Are you saying that they're getting the homes for free? Is that what you're saying?
I don't know. I don't know what they're getting them for. I don't know how to find that out. I just see that they're the ones getting them. And my sister's house, it sold, and it sold to Mexican people. And I think there was Mexican, I'm not sure.
Mexican.
And
huh?
Then my nephew's house sold, and it sold. And there's nobody, as far as I know, even living there still.
Yeah.
But it sold.
I can.
And they got houses right down here on our road. Three or four houses been sitting empty.
Yeah, and so you're saying you're frustrated because you see all these empty houses and you can't find a place to go?
But we can't even find out who we can call about them.
Yeah.
Well, and we're talking, some of these houses was last year.
Well, Ms. Shiflett, that's why I was calling, because I know how frustrating it is. Like, you know, we're trying to buy the house, and I understand that probably moving is such a stress for you guys, and finding a place to go is so stressful, and you just don't want to go anywhere. You want to find a home, you know?
Yes.
Well, I want to do my best to help out, because I don't want you guys to go into foreclosure and lose the house and have your credit ruined. That's my goal, is to avoid that from happening and get you some money.
As soon as he gets back in, I'll tell him he has to call you.
Yeah, I'm okay.
I say the house is not in my name, so I can't do anything.
Yeah, I understand. Tell him to call me at this number. My name is Nathan. I work with Jacqueline, and I'm kind of taking over to help out, because, again, I understand the situation's rough. I wish you the best. I hope you're okay. You just left the hospital, so I hope everything's okay.
I'm just taking some medicine right now.
Okay. By the way, do you mind if I ask you what happened? I'm just curious.
I'd rather you just talk to him.
Okay. All right. All right, Ms. Shiflett. Well, you rest up, and I'll look forward to talking to your husband, all right?
All right. Thank you.
Yeah. You have a good one. See ya.
You too. Bye-bye.
All right, bye. All right, so we know who the decision maker is in that, and it is not Ms. Shiflett, it is Mr. Shiflett. I called him, he did not answer. Now look, this is the problem. They don't have a place to go. They're gonna lose their home, they're pre-foreclosure, and they're gonna lose it. So it's either we help them get out and we move them, even though they're old, she's just got the hospital, she can't get out. They probably can't even pack a box. They're probably not capable. I mean, he looks like he's working two jobs. This is a very difficult situation. What can we do to help? How can we get this deal across the finish line? Again, it's not about money. Sometimes you just gotta help. We are gonna make money on this, but we gotta make sure we can help them reach their goal. Now, their credit's terrible. I don't honestly know what I'll do to get them into a new place, but I know that if we don't convince them and prove to them that if they don't take action now, it's going to be a lot worse. We're willing to pay them and move them. Like, we're willing to help out. So, interesting situation. She said that Mexicans were moving in her neighborhood. I don't know. I don't think she's racist. I hope not. And if she is, that's okay. For me, I'm not saying it's okay she's racist. I just don't care. I'll help out someone with the race. I don't even care. Whatever. It doesn't matter, because she's a nice lady and she's been raised probably in a different circumstance than what we have, that's younger generation. So who cares? Who cares if she, thinks differently? That doesn't impact the way we got to help her. So the next step would to create a follow-up task to call Mr. Shiflett and reach out and talk to him. Ms. Shiflett's out of it. She doesn't care. She just got back from the hospital. She's sick. What can we do with Mr. Shiflet? That is the next step. If we can get them to move, then the deal is done. That's it. If we just force them out, if we just say, hey, you know, play hardball, it's probably not going to work. The dude works nonstop. That's what needs to be done. Okay. So that's what you do with deals. You got to look at what's happening and say, what's the next step to get it done? Because if you just make an offer and then hope, you're like, I hope it gets done. Not going to work. You got to almost like hold people's hand to the closing table occasionally. All right. And by the way, a lot of this, what I'm telling you guys is stuff that I teach in my mind map. That's why this little thing's going across. If you want it, it's absolutely free. Check out my mind map. I explain the steps to doing business, doing this the painless way. And we already have a buyer. So this is why it's painless. It's not like we're just randomly, you know, trying to do the deal.